I tried testing it, but if you want to go in there and talk to the microphone, that would help me. All right.
I
have it already. It's not working quite right.
Was that obvious?
Hold on.
What are you doing? When'd you get that camera?
Oh, God. Well, Cindy and Andy were over, so it was probably about May.
Man, I kind of like those.
Those viewfinders are not.
They're a little different. Yeah, I guess it's better.
Battery's low.
I'm going to go take a picture of you.
Jamie Lou.
Where's Nancy?
She's in there.
Wow.
Right there.
Alicia, this is a big night. You've anticipated this for a long time, and it's finally come. And So a lot of you may not know Alicia that well. I've known her ever since she was born, and she is truly a very, very special, special young lady. Alicia, what's about to take place tonight is something you'll remember the rest of your life. We would challenge you to write it down and put it in a journal, and that you can refer back to it. But it's the first of many great blessings that's going to take place in your life, and it will long be remembered. In a few minutes, Elias will go with you, and we'll all follow, and he will walk down into the water, and he will raise his hand to the square, and he will say, Alicia Marie Monica, having been commissioned of Jesus Christ, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. We use the word commission because he has been commissioned by Jesus Christ to do your baptism. I looked up the word commission in the dictionary, and in the dictionary, commission says, authority granted for a particular action or function. In this case, Elder Anders was commissioned, that is, he received the authority to baptize, having received authority direct from Jesus Christ, and rather a line of authority from Jesus Christ. And we can trace his line of authority, where he received his authority, and where the person before that he received his authority from, and trace it back directly to Jesus Christ. And then after that, he will baptize you. You will be completely immersed in the water, and you will come out of the water. And at that point, your sins will be completely washed away. Now, hopefully, there won't be any change in the color of the water. But you will feel a cleansing of the soul. And that will be done because of the atoning washing that is done by the Savior. And it's something that you will feel, and as you go through the evening, and as you finish and later receive the Holy Ghost, you can go home and kneel down before the Father this evening, and really, you will notice a difference in your life because you were baptized. It will not be just because of you were baptized, but you have made a commitment that you will keep the commandments from this day forth, that you will honor Him and serve the Savior with all your heart, mind, and strength. And I have a testimony that Anders does have authority to baptize you in the name of our other brother. And I just want to say these things in the name of Jesus Christ.
Thank you.
continue with our program by having a talk on the Holy Ghost by Sister DiGiovanni after the confirmation.
Well, first of all, I want to thank Alicia for asking me to speak at her baptism. I did actually ask to speak on the Holy Ghost because it's one of my favorite topics. So even though I'm nervous, I'm very happy to be here. When I first joined the church 4.5 years ago, I learned something about the Holy Ghost. I learned that there were actually two different types of the Holy Ghost that people often talked about. One was the power of the Holy Ghost, and the other one was the gift of the Holy Ghost. And it took me a long time to really understand the difference between the two. But I know, Alicia, I know you know a lot about the Holy Ghost. I know that you prepared a talk for next week that's about the Holy Ghost. And I know that you know that it testifies of truth. And that's the reason why you were actually baptized tonight, because you felt the truth from the Holy Ghost. I know that we talked a little bit about the Holy Ghost and the gift of the Holy Ghost. Tonight, in a few minutes, you're going to be confirmed with the man, and you're going to be receiving the gift of the Holy Ghost. And I kind of like to share something with you. This helped me to kind of understand the difference between the two. This is a bottle of perfume. You can see it's partly used up. I received this as a gift last year for Christmas. It was a very special gift because it's a very special perfume, and I love this perfume. But you see, it's almost gone, and it's going to be used up shortly, and then it's not going to be of very much use to me. Tonight, Alicia, you're going to be receiving a different kind of gift, but it is a gift. It's a very valuable gift. It's a lot different than this gift because it can't be used up. It can't be worn out. In fact, it gets more valuable as it is used up. So, in fact, actually, I'd like to share something with you that came up from one of the ensigns. Elder James Faust was giving a first presidency message. This is what he said. The gift of the Holy Ghost entitles a person who is desirous and worthy to enjoy the power and light of truth of the Holy Ghost. It is the comforting spirit of the Holy Ghost that can abide with us 24 hours a day, when we work, when we play, when we rest. Its strengthening influence can be with us year in and year out. That sustaining influence can be with us in joy and sorrow, when we rejoice as well as when we grieve. And just so that we all know what we're actually talking about when we're talking about the Holy Ghost, I'd like to share with you, it's in Doctrine and Covenants. It actually explains why the Holy Ghost is a person of spirit. It says, the Father has a body of flesh and bones as tangible as man's, the Son also, but the Holy Ghost has not a body of flesh and bones, but is a personage of spirit. Were it not so, the Holy Ghost could not dwell in us. And so, Alicia, in a few minutes, you're going to be receiving the gift of the Holy Ghost. And this, as you go through life and you live worthily, you will be able to have the constant companion of the Holy Ghost, to be able to testify not only truthfulness to you, but it will help you, it will help strengthen your faith. It will help you to choose correct decisions. So if you're going down the path and you meet up with temptation, that Holy Ghost is going to be right there telling you of the gospel law. It'll put the gospel principle in your mind that you've been taught, so that you can live worthily to that and resist temptation. And that's why it's so important for you and all of us to live worthily, so that we can always be worthy and have this Holy Ghost to be with us. I'm so proud of you, Alicia. I'm so happy that you've made this decision in your life. And I say these things in the name of my son, Jesus Christ.
Well, Alicia, now you're officially a member of the church. No matter where you go in life, no matter where you live, you'll always be a member of this church. Your name will follow you on a record. You'll always know where you are, and you'll be able to help take care of all your special needs. Bishop Masino will now welcome you into the ward, after which we'll have our closing hymn on St. Olaf on page 193, after which Sister Wendy will close the prayer.
Sometimes I get worried about having to speak so often. We're having wonderful baptism after baptism. Usually the council is the same. I officially want to welcome you into the church, and I should. It's a privilege to see someone baptized, like I said just before. It reminds us of our own baptisms. And those are wonderful times, because it means that for most of us, at least us adults, we've made some major changes in our lives. One of the things I guess I'd like to just encourage you to do is keep coming to church every Sunday, participate in the primary. Next year, you'll be in the Young Women's Program. And they do many wonderful things, things that will strengthen the testimony of Jesus Christ. The most wonderful thing I think we do in this church is we try to learn the scriptures and apply them in our lives. And we try to do our very best to be a close family, both at home and here at church. We do care about all those who join, and we become part of our family. And I think our Father in Heaven wants us as your leaders and your teachers to do our very best to give you an opportunity to return once again to your Father in Heaven. And the way we do that is by obeying the commandments, is by being kind and loving. And sometimes one of the things that's hardest for most of us, both young children and adults sometimes, is we gotta learn how to become loving and forgiving. Sometimes I've seen people get upset about something and then be mad at that brother or sister. And all that really does is harbor the wrong kind of feelings in our hearts. Our Father in Heaven and our Lord Jesus Christ told us to forgive one another and to move on. But one of the greatest things I hope you and your family, I'm going to put a little pressure on Nancy back there. I hope you and your family take the opportunity to have family meetings, to take time to study spiritual things, but also other things. I'll never forget how my wife just taught our girls how to set a table, proper etiquette about certain things. I think it's important that we try to teach our children the traditions that we have. And most important of all, we should pray as a family, and we should pray as an individual. So every once in a while, remind everybody, hey, we haven't had a prayer in a while. Let's get down on our knees and have a family prayer. Into the fair water, and I'm very proud that you made this decision, and Nancy, you supported it. So I just want you to know how much we appreciate that. And I think by trying to live as our Lord Jesus Christ wants us to, we bring joy into our lives. And I say these things in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you.
continue to be with her and continue to help her to remember the feelings that she felt this day as she entered into the waters of baptism. Help her to always remember these memories and hold them close to her heart as she goes through her life, that she may be able to look back on them and gain strength from that experience. We give thanks for the blessings we have received, and we love you, Lord.